Hello, Freedom Call 82. Thank you for your post on my page. See, you left me a question about what tablets I'm on. Originally, I kind of got things a bit wrong. You said the drug, I've got its name now, Salaplax. It's actually olanzapine. Actually, I have been on olanzapine, which is a name probably in England. That's probably a different name for it in America. Yes, the drug had a different effect on me, though. When I took it, I felt like I was a zombie and had no... So you left me a question about what tablets I'm on. Originally, I kind of got things a bit wrong. You said the drug, I've got its name now, Salaplax. It's actually olanzapine. Actually, I have been on olanzapine, which is a name probably in England. That's probably a different name for it in America. Yes, the drug had a different effect on me, though. When I took it, I felt like I was a zombie and had no personality, had no feelings of things, anything. And it actually caused me a lot of problems with my friendships and my friends at the time, because, to be honest, I had an attitude. I was not, I suppose really you could call it, aggression, but I wasn't interested and didn't care about anyone else's problems, it kind of thing like that. It did make me calmer in some ways, but the drug was something I wouldn't take again. I am now on, I forgot its name, was supposed to be on, but I'm off it again at the moment. 20 milligrams of something. We'll have to look that up. I will send you a message about that, but yes, the drug has caused me problems. And see, I'm not on the tablets, not because I don't have to be. Like, I don't have to be on the tablets, but I'm not on the tablets for the reason that if I was on those tablets, it's just that I would get addicted to them, kind of thing. So, now anyone that's watching this about mental health, I'm not saying you should refuse your tablets or anything like that, but that's just how that's just my way. Now, I'm physically, mentally quite strong, so I'm very, I've not been big, I've got an IQ 172, so I'm quite able to tell fact from fiction, which I think actually helps them well. There's another blog which I've got linked up now. If you look on the page, if you want to see how I deal with bipolar, some of you might have seen it, I think you might have, but please do take a look at it. But yeah, look forward to hearing from you, my friend. But bipolar is a nasty one. Like I said before, a girl called Zoe, not the Zoe that posted below you, that's just a different Zoe. A girl I know called Bipolar Zoe, from Kingsbridge. I won't say any last names or anything like that because of confidentiality. The one I had a bit of problem with her last year, she had major problems. She was on tablets all the time, and I know she was a bit off the rails even with the tablets, but I think we all got our own different ways of treatment to deal with mental illness. One of the funniest ones, this is actually, I'm going to big up a group called Rethink, a mental health worker called Graham Hopkinson. You know who you are, my friend. Sometimes we get schizophrenia bipolar, we talk to ourselves. Now, this is a good technique I want to teach anyone here to make it look like it's more socially acceptable within the thing. I can just find, oh god, I can't find my mobile. Okay, well, that didn't go as planned. I couldn't find my mobile, but there's different ways of dealing with it. See, sometimes when you're out in the open and you get a schizophrenia or bipolar and you start talking to yourself, don't forget you've always got a mobile phone at hand, or in this case a packet of cigarettes, but you know, and might feel a bit uncomfortable talking to yourself in the middle of nowhere, so just pretend you're mobile, you're talking to somebody on your mobile and you're having one, and kind of thing. I don't get this, but I don't do it myself, kind of thing, but some people do, and I just pretend you're talking to someone, like, hello, you alright? Yeah, not so bad, and just talk about your problems on the mobile, pretend that someone's there. It actually does work. I know it sounds stupid, but a mobile is a lifesaver when it comes to bipolar or schizophrenia. So perhaps consider using your mobile if you've got one, and pretend you're talking to somebody on the phone. It might help you. So there you go. That's all I deal with bipolar and schizophrenia. But please do keep in contact. I look forward to hearing you soon. Any more questions I can answer, ask the doctor. And speaking of doctors, actually not a real doctor, a medical doctor, but for some reason I seem to be in a praying stance at the moment. That's just me drawing an idea. Got this idea from having a video that should be in large screen from Dr. Seuss. So I want to also say thank you to him for the idea of what he does in his videos. So keep watching. Thank you, and speak to you all soon. And here's my friend, God.